Now, it may seem obvious, but this tree structure that we've described as being one of the advantages of AF, the structure that allows you to navigate either conceptually or, geographically, this is how we create it, using what we've just demonstrated by creating brand new elements where they are required. So, for example, underneath line A, I want to create a heat exchanger A. I'll just create a new element. It's going to be a strong relationship. That's the parent-child. And this is what's going to be called heat exchanger A. So it's through doing this that you gradually create that structure. Now, those of you who have very large projects, you may look at this and say, well, you've got to be kidding. I have to do this one at a time. We actually are in the process of creating a tool that allow you to do this as a bulk edit using Excel. And in fact, if you're a member of vCampus, you can download the pre-release version of that. That's known as the AF Builder, and you'll find that in the Community Technology Preview section. So that's what you could do if you needed to build this in mass. So I'm going to go ahead and add a heat exchanger B. I could have also copied and pasted this. We'll go over the different options when copying and pasting. So to demonstrate the usefulness of being able to have this hierarchy, have the same object in two different places, let me just demonstrate. First of all, I'm just going to drag this over, heat exchanger A, to put it under the heat exchangers. You notice automatically what this is doing is it's actually pasting a reference, and that's asking me what type of a reference do I want. I'm going to do the strong reference, the parent-child. So you can see now this appears in two different places. I can do the same for heat exchanger B. I'll just drag this over to under heat exchangers, make it parent-child. And now we see heat exchanger A and B. Now those are just references, and I can tell the references. First of all, the little icon shows me it's a reference. And then also if I go in and I create, well, let's just create a new attribute. We'll talk more about attributes later on, but every heat exchanger is going to have a measure of area. Let's say we have a measure of area that's at 45. And we'll do more on working with attributes later on. But what I wanted to demonstrate is notice how when I edited that right here, it also picked up that attribute over here, because all this is a reference to where you would find the original. Now this is the parent, this is using a parent-child reference type. So that means that this will not be deleted, this heat exchanger will not be deleted unless all of the parents are deleted. So in this case right now, we've got a parent-child, a strong relationship between both this line A heat exchanger and the heat exchanger A under heat exchangers.